you're asked to consider whether you have any disclosable pecuniary or any other relevant interest in connection with any matters to be determined at this meeting. And if so, it declares the state of nature of such interest. May I remind you that should you state the item number, it should state the item number entitled to the nature of your interest. Okay, item two, Civic Mayor's announcements. They notified of the following apologies. Adrian Jones, Paul Dowsey. Adrian Jones, Paul Dowsey, Chris Jones, Jean Stapleton, Shelley Pogle, and John Hale. I believe John Hale will call it. Can we send our best wishes to the Province Council? Yeah. Are there any further apologies?
Mr. Mayor, Catherine Mitchell is not able to attend.
Thank you. Okay. Also, during the announcements, I'd like to congratulate and welcome all the seven newly elected members and those successfully re-elected. Can I give me indulgence when I read them out? If you don't mind, one by one. Bidson St. James, Julie McManus. Welcome, Julie. Bromborough. Warren Ward, welcome Warren. Liscard, Tom Usher, welcome Tom. New Brighton, Tony Jones, welcome Tony. Oxton, welcome return to Stuart Kelly. Seacombe, Paul Stewart, welcome Paul. And welcome return to Ian Lewis in Wallasey. Welcome Ian. Okay, still on.
I'm pretty sure you could have possibly been.
I don't want to use me down early on. Right, as I was saying, I've got some more concerns. So bear with me, Councillor Drew. As you know, freedom of the board
submit a petition of 355 signatures to have the signatures for the minutes recorded.
Thank you. More petitions?
Thank you for your points.
Thank you. Secondly, I've decided to appoint a cabinet member to focus on addressing our public health challenges, and I'm delighted that Jeanette Williamson will be joining the cabinet to take on that role. I really want the borough to raise our game generally on public health. We know that we've got some really, really big challenges around some of the key public health challenges that face us: obesity, poor diet, smoking, alcohol-related illnesses. And I think it'll be the role of this cabinet member and this post to engage with our schools, our GPs, leisure centres and communities to look at ways in which residents, especially younger people, can follow a more active lifestyle, making better lifestyle choices. And I'm absolutely confident that Jeanette will do an excellent job in that new role. The remainder of the cabinet will clearly focus, as I say, on our 20 pledges in the plan. In terms of the priority around the people elements of the plan, Chris Jones will continue to do the work she's been doing around adult social care, and Tony Smith will continue as the cabinet member for children and family services. And we've got a big agenda around those two areas particularly.
terms of the priority in the plan around environment, Bernie Mooney will continue to lead on this portfolio, particularly focusing on some of the key issues that we looked at last year around how we can crack down on littering, fly tipping, and with particular focus in this coming year on tackling dog fouling, which I know is an issue across the borough that comes to members' attention. And we'll also be doing our best and doing our bit on climate change by particularly focusing on improving our recycling rates, and I think that's really welcome. Last but not least, George Davis will take on the lead on delivering our pledges around building new houses and tackling antisocial behaviour. And we know that the latter issue was a high priority for local residents when we did our Moray survey last year. And George will also serve this year as deputy leader of the council. I'm really delighted that George will do that role. Mr. Mayor, in closing, I'd like to take this opportunity of thanking both Chris Beaman and Adrian Jones for their service on the cabinet for the past year, and wish them all the best in the new roles which I've asked them to carry out in the forthcoming year. There's copies available of the cabinet, the list of cabinet members and cabinet portfolios Andrew's got, but in summary, Mr. Mayor, that's my proposed cabinet and cabinet members for the forthcoming year. Thank you.
Yeah.
detail you apply for on the leader to yourself. So I'm sure it's going to help you a bit more.
Yeah, okay. Yes, I'm happy to respond to Phil's question. So Phil's written to me to ask about the new arrangements with the combined authority and the devolution deal. Firstly, Phil asks, can I make a statement about how appointed members of the combined authority will involve its council's members? Well, the answer to that is that clearly, as leader, I will bring a regular report to full council on the devolution deal and the combined authority, and any member can ask a question on that. But also, and this is not a matter for me, the scrutiny committee, our scrutiny committees, perfectly possible for them to do a specific piece of work around devolution and combined authority. I'd be happy to appear before the scrutiny committee, and I would, you know, I would suggest that might be something that the scrutiny committees may wish to consider as part of their work programme in the forthcoming year. So that was the first question, Phil. And then the second question was, as part of the devolution agreement with government, clearly the combined authority is in the process of pulling together a new constitution that will take on board the new powers and responsibilities that we've been given, which we discussed here when the devolution deal was being consulted on. This is in the form of a newly kind of legal framework for the combined authority. Now that is being drafted as we speak, and it's going to be formally considered by the combined authority on the 18th of June. Now thereafter, I think from the 24th of June, once the new referendums are out of the way, check the surgery before, there'll be a 6-week period when this new legal framework can be considered by all six councils. So every member on this authority will have an opportunity to consider that. It's perfectly possible we can have a special scrutiny committee or whatever forum to consider that. But there'll be a 6-week period for each council to consider how best it wishes to respond to this new legal framework, which is drafted at the moment. So hopefully that should provide ample time for us to make our comments once we've had an opportunity to obviously read the document. The second element to all of that is there is at the moment a scrutiny committee that is attached to the combined authority, which scrutinises the work of the combined authority. And we've got a couple of amendments on that. Now, my understanding is the government is in the process of producing guidance on, once we've set up the new mayoral cabinet and all that, how the scrutiny arrangements might work. Now, I haven't seen that guidance yet. I'm not sure when it's due out. But as soon as we've got that, we'll make sure that's circulated to all members.